Thank you, Mr. Speaker, and I thank my colleague from Texas and also the gentleman from Florida for allowing us the time to speak here on this very important event for not just El Paso and not just for Texas, but for our whole country, for a whole generation of players and those that have benefited from their accomplishments. I rise today in strong support, Mr. Speaker, of HRS 668, a resolution that celebrates the 40th anniversary of Texas Western's 1966 NCAA Basketball Championship. And in that, recognizing the groundbreaking impact of that title game victory on diversity in sports. And of course, on the impact, of, as my colleagues have stated, of civil rights in America. I am proud to have introduced this bill and honored to have the opportunity to speak in this chamber today about the importance of what a basketball team and a coach achieved 40 years ago. This afternoon, I want to thank Leader Boehner and Chairman McKeon and Ranking Member Miller for their support in bringing this very important legislation to the floor. On March 19, 1966, the Miners of Texas Western, which is now UTEP, led by Coach Don Haskins, defeated the University of Kentucky at Cole Field House in College Park, Maryland. This significant championship game gave the NCAA Basketball Championship at a crucial time to Texas Western College. At a time when bitter politics of racism dictated to many coaches around the country who got to play, Coach Haskins started five black players in the NCAA Basketball Championship game. The first time in America that this country had seen an all-black starting lineup in a major championship contest. In 1966, as a strengthening civil rights movement met poisonous political dispute and violence, the Miners were able to clearly demonstrate to a nation and to the sports world the virtue of desegregation and equality. As the athletic establishment abided by that unwritten rule that said, play two on the road, three if you're really behind, referring, of course, to black players. Coach Haskins looked past the color of the player's skin and concentrated on winning games and eventually the national championship. Years later, Coach Haskins would say, and I quote, "I just played my best guys like any coach would do." That simple, principled courage changed the course of American athletics and provided an important advance in the struggle of civil rights in our nation. The Texas Western Championship was an event defined by many as the Brown versus Board of Education of athletics. Like many whose lives were constrained by their appearance and background, I found extraordinary significance in that 1966 game. Because I was a Texas Western student during the fall semester of 1965 and had an opportunity to see these great players play. Shortly thereafter, I was drafted into the Army and eventually went on to fight in Vietnam. In March of 1966, I was still in El Paso, only stationed at Fort Bliss doing basic training. For those of us who were in the military at the time, the hypocrisy of America's racial policies were very clear. We saw a country that would not hesitate to send black and Hispanic soldiers to fight and die in foreign wars, but would not fight for us back at home. Coach Haskins and the Miners' victory helped reveal to a nation the absurdity of racism and the futility of segregation. I returned from Vietnam and chose a career in public service, in a career in which my successes followed from my abilities and my own hard work. Of course, I found that life does not abide by that perfect rule of a game like basketball. But I remain inspired today by Texas Western's win. And I know that I would not have had the opportunities I did have had it not been for the courage of people like Don Haskins and his Miners. Today, a university, a city, and a country are improved by the achievement of that 1966 team. Soon after that championship, Texas Western became the University of Texas at El Paso, or as we call it now, UTEP. And its basketball program continued to thrive under Coach Haskins until his retirement, as my colleagues have said, in 1999. Coach Haskins eventually led UTEP to 32 winning seasons, 7 Western Athletic Conference championships, 4 Western Athletic Conference tournament titles, and 21 postseason appearances. Last year, the Miners won 27 games, 16 at our own Don Haskins Center in El Paso, named after our great coach. And they also earned a spot in the NCAA tournament. This year, they are again near the top of their conference. Could I ask for an additional 2 minutes?
Yes, I will yield the gentleman another minute.
Without objection.
This year, they are near the top of their conference, and once again, a testament to the enduring tradition of college basketball successes created by Don Haskins. The university itself has been transformed from a small mining school into a hub of athletic excellence and world-class research. El Paso, long proud of its Miners and their NCAA championship, has enjoyed the attention of a nation this year, as millions of Americans have fallen in love with the Miners through the recently released film, Glory Road, which is currently being shown around the country. It is especially important for us to honor the 1966 Miners today on the eve of their accomplishment, here shown in that championship game against Kentucky. We must revise a historical injustice, the injustice of a group of men being judged by who they were, not how they played. At the time, the university or the Texas Western Miners were denied an opportunity to appear on the Ed Sullivan Show. But just last week, I want to commend President Bush and First Lady Laura Bush as they honored this team at the White House, shown here in this photograph with our president, the original members of that 66 championship teams. So this afternoon, I want to congratulate Coach Don Haskins, Bobby Joe Hill, Orston Artis, Togo Riley, Willie Worsley, David Palacio, Dick Myers, Harry Flournoy. An additional 30 seconds to get...
I yield an additional 20 seconds.
Without objection.
Harry Flournoy, Louis Baudin, Neville Shedd, Jerry Armstrong, Willie Cager, and David Big Daddy Latin on the occasion of the 40th anniversary of their NCAA championship for all of their successes in their lives. Today, we also remember, of course, Bobby Joe Hill, who died and was unable to be in this photograph here in 2002. So, Mr. Speaker, I strongly urge my colleagues to support HRES 668.
Gentlemen,
and with that, I yield back the balance of my time.